your cat as much as Jess loves hers? Well, then you'd know that buying special furniture and things to keep them entertained can get really pricey, but we're about to show you how to make your own feline fun using cat hacks. TV vet Katrina Warren joins us now to show us how it's done. Hello! And furniture hacking have become hugely popular, and it's no surprise that we're heading into pet hack territory.
Absolutely. So pet hacks are basically making toys and things for your cat to keep them entertained out of everyday items.
Okay.
It's a really cute Whiskers campaign, and basically this is the first one we've got, which is making a cat scratch out of, look at this.
And well, do you think would James like to hop on it?
I don't know if James would like to hop on it yet. James is very active, by the way.
Oh,
hi, James.
Beautiful.
Isn't he beautiful?
He matches. Yeah. He matches this.
He does match. So let me show you how thrifty we can be. This is actually a doormat. So you cut a piece of doormat. I know, you get a solid frame, solid piece of frame, doormat, glue it. This is not glued down, but you glue it down. So everything has to be very solid. Obviously, if cats are going to use it. Yep. Attached to the frame, and look. Here's one we prepared earlier.
And you hang that on the wall.
You hang that on the wall. So obviously safety is important. So you hang it on the wall at an area where your cat can reach. So it's really important with cats that they can stretch up to scratch. So they need to be able to reach their full length. And then you teach them how to use it. So big mistake.
How? Do you demonstrate?
What you do, go Jess.
Do you go...
Pretty much, actually.
This is a dramatic reaction.
Pretty much, except you get a toy. So the quickest way... Would you like a toy? Quickest way is to dangle a toy. Get your cat playing with the toy up and down the post, right? Or Jess's fingernails will do just fine.
And it will save your couch, because I remember when I had a cat, it was this costly.
My couch is destroyed. Destroyed.
Yeah. Save your couch. So I always recommend with scratches to get a couple of different scratches around the house. Use material that is rough. So this is perfect sisal-type material cats tend to love, but you have to teach them how to use it.
Well, here's the question. If they've already used the couch and they're practiced on using the couch, how do you get them to switch?
You redirect. You cover that area of your couch with something short term, and you redirect them constantly onto something like this. So you spend 5 or 10 minutes a couple of times a day playing with them on this material, and they usually, once they get the knack of it, they usually go for it.
Okay. And also doubles as a piece of modern art.
And why should we keep our pussycats active?
Because cats, these days most people keep their cats indoors, which is fantastic for their safety. Indoor cats, I know how cute is that. They need something to do. So you can keep the cat indoors, but they still have the same instincts to scratch, to climb. Climbing is a big one, and there's some clever cat hacks you can use with actually using like box frames and things that you can put up on your wall so cats can climb them. You're determined there, Jess, aren't you?
I want to teach little James, who's looking for a home.
Who's teaching who?
How cool is James, by the way? We've literally dragged poor James out of Animal Welfare League. He needs a home.
Yep.
He's got a little sibling here as well called Daniel. They're at Animal Welfare League Ingleside Shelter, ready to go to homes. Absolutely beautiful, really outgoing. I don't know how much he's loving you, Jess, right now, but he would love a loving home.
How old is James?
James is, I think he's 11 weeks of age.
We'll put all those details on our Facebook page so people can certainly inquire if they need a forever animal in their home. But let's go back to the life hacks.
Yep.
What other ones have you got?
Some of the cat ones. We've got a fantastic, we've got a feeder, a clock feeder, where you can, oh, here we go, the lookout. Here we go. That is the home entertainment centre. The simplest cat hack you can do is give your cat a box. A hammock, which is made out of just using something like a table runner attached to a piece of furniture you already have. This is the cat feeder, which is pretty cool. Use a clock and a little plate, and then it feeds at a certain time in the day.
Well, it gets moved around by the hands.
Yeah, absolutely. And this one, all you need is someone to drill, make a little round entrance point, and you can put those up on the walls. I've spent a lot of time in the States, and a lot of people have really, in New York, they use the cat hacks to make more vertical space, we call it, using allowing cats to climb up the side of the walls because they don't have a lot of space.
It's like a little mouse wheel, that other thing.
Isn't it? Exercise wheel. The exercise wheel. Mm. They're really, really clever. They're part of, it's a Whiskers campaign, just encouraging people to get creative and also perhaps to donate something to your shelter as well.
And was that a cat hammock I saw before?
Cat hammock. Good. Cats love to lie in, they just love to lie in high places. So you can put a hammock, you know, underneath a coffee table or somewhere higher as well. Obviously, you've got to make it nice and
secure. Have a cat nap.
And you can check all the videos, Whiskers Australia Facebook page. All the cat hacks are there.
It
how
really
to make them.
Is. Dr. Katrina Warren, thank you very much for coming in.
Thank you.
Owen, hang on. And if Katrina mentioned, we also need to thank Animal Welfare New South Wales for bringing in these ready-to-adopt adorable kittens. Their website is up on your screen if you are thinking about doing a good thing and adopting a homeless animal. We'll see the details on our Facebook page.
You're holding a cat, you look more handsome with a cat.
Very handsome.